I'm Tanuja Vikramarachchi from Postgraduate Institute of Medicine, University of Colombo. My study is regarding the compliance to medical nutrition therapy and physical exercise among mothers with gestational diabetes mellitus delivering at two maternity hospitals in Colombo. Similar to other non-communicable diseases, the prevalence of gestational diabetes mellitus is also gradually increasing in Sri Lanka. But it is found that proper glycemic control in gestational diabetes mellitus by medical nutrition therapy and physical exercise prevents many maternal and fetal complications. Therefore, the objective of our study was to describe the factors associated with compliance to medical nutrition therapy and exercise among mothers with gestational diabetes mellitus delivering at two selected tertiary care maternity hospitals in Colombo. This is a descriptive cross-sectional study carried out among mothers diagnosed with gestational diabetes mellitus who delivered at Dissoisa Hospital for Women and Castle Street Hospital for Women in Colombo. Our sample size was 265, which was recruited through consecutive sampling. An interviewer-administered questionnaire and a data extraction sheet were used to collect data. The data was analyzed for factors associated with poor compliance to medical nutrition therapy and exercise. Here we define poor compliance as adherence to medical advice less than 90% of the time. When we look at the results, regarding medical nutrition therapy, most of the mothers, that is 93.6% of the mothers, had clear information. But adequate compliance was seen only in 54% of the mothers. Regarding physical exercise, 93% of the mothers had clear information regarding physical exercise, but only 41% of the mothers had adequate compliance to that. When we look at the factors associated with this poor compliance, we noted that with poor compliance to medical nutrition therapy, the lack of time, lack of family support, craving for food, financial difficulties, unclear advices, not perceiving the importance of compliance was statistical significant association with poor compliance to medical nutrition therapy. The odds ratio is more than 2. With poor compliance to physical exercise, lack of time, lack of proper place to exercise, social stigma, physical discomfort, not perceiving the importance of compliance and unclear advices showed statistically significant associations with poor compliance to physical exercise with odds ratios more than 1.7. Therefore, we concluded that improving knowledge on medical nutrition therapy and physical exercise is not just adequate to ensure proper compliance during pregnancy. We need lifestyle changes with improved skills of proper time management, family support, and attitudinal change. They should be promoted to improve the compliance for medical nutrition therapy and physical exercise. And finally, I want to declare that there are no conflicts of interest in this study. Thank you.